Here we go again on my own. This is Sancho West, and welcome to Sweet 16 episode of Sir Daniel's Quest for Black Belt. And we are still in the upper green. And I'm going to take that for granted because I've been all the way from 50 green back to 90 green, back down to 50. And I'm happy that we got back to 89 green. And we have facing some Sly Coopers here in Isaac. And I want to appreciate you guys for sticking with me during this green trials and tribulation, during the green sludge, the green slurm, the green slurpee, the green nastiness that right now I'm going through. And I'm trying to get to purple belt in a timely fashion because I am running out of time due to my schedule and whatnot. And you know, I didn't foresee this series going into one. I didn't foresee you guys liking the series this much, and that's awesome right off the bat. Thank you guys. Oh, I missed right there with my level one. I'm trying to kill this Isaac that left because, like I've been saying, a lot of people, they're gonna get this kill and I want this kill. And it's a free kill, so sue me. It's a free kill, but I don't want anyone else to get that free kill. I got to definitely get it off the table. But as I was saying, you guys are awesome. You know, I didn't really expect this much support for it right out the gate. I thought it was just a silly quest. But you know, you guys are attached to it, and I'm committed to getting Sir Daniel's black belt. And you've heard me say this plenty of times. If they reset the belts, thank God, Santa Monica Studios. You guys are paying attention to us. Finally, we've been neglected so long. So I will just start all over. We'll go from scratch. But now that I shook off some rust, and I'm seeing what's happening in the gaming community of places, also Battle Royale. Ah, man, two whiffs do not make a right. No, sir. And I'm seeing how you guys are playing, and I'm seeing the new adjustments people are making towards Sir Dan. Maybe I shouldn't have made videos or early on exposing Sir Dan's greatness, because now people are getting wise to it. And, yeah, so I got some new things to learn. But that's the great thing about it. You're going to see the rawness, the good, the bad, the ugly, going all the way from the bottom to the top of the Sir Dan. And you're going to say, hey, I was there. I was there when he was crying. I was there when he was losing the black belts of Kratos and Raiden. I was there when he was stuck in the green belt for 20-plus episodes, it feels like. And so that's what's awesome about that. And then, as my previous announcement, we're going to do 2v2 Sir Daniel's quest for black belt. I want to get you guys involved into helping Sir Dan get his black belt in 2v2. Which will probably be, you know, pretty cool. I've never done this before in terms of fan interaction YouTube videos, but I want to bring you guys into the party. And once I figure out the, you know, how am I gonna execute it, you guys will be the first to know. But only subscribers could play along. If you guys haven't heard that announcement, so please subscribe. And once we get, TMZ Sly Cooper, don't you dare take my picture of me without my consent. No, I'm suing you. I'm suing you for all that you have, you raccoon. Oh, yeah, more pictures of him. Oh, don't see me now.
Oh, God, no. Dang, he took a picture of me without my consent.
That's kind of, my Sir Dan kind of sounds like, if, I don't know. Oh, cookies. Dang. No, not even a kill. Not a good match. My Sir Dan impression sounds like Ricky from I Love Lucy. I probably just dated myself. But I Love Lucy is an awesome show.
Lucy, where are you?
Come here. Oh, yes. Oh, no cookies, but I don't think I got that victory. Nope. Sad bear. Last place. 2-2, and that's not going to bode well with my belt ranking. Oh, okay. I didn't far down that. I didn't drop that far below, but we got a red belt, brown belt here. Hopefully, I can mooch off of that. And I need to get a win. I need to get a win so we can get back closer to the 90s, because that means I will get, you know, a couple steps closer. And hopefully you guys won't tire of my green belt struggles. But we're in this together. So if you have any comments or suggestions, or, you know, if you have positive comments about my gameplay in terms of my skills. And remember, I'm still shaking off the rust. I used to play this game way back in the day, like almost every day for a couple hours straight. And since this game kind of fell off the wayside and has been left in the cold, stranded, without a water or anything like that, wandering the desert aimlessly. And what is this fat princess doing to me? Stop bringing out your minions. Go way. You fat. Okay, look. Big girls need love too, but fat princesses, you were skinny and now you're bulbously fat. And you're killing me with your dwarves. Oh, I almost had you. I don't have anything against big girls. I just don't like fat princess because she likes to... Oh, I missed. Because she likes to eat her cake too, and that's not cool. You selfish girl. I don't know. Why am I mean, sir? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be mean to you, fat princess. You're cool. You're cool. I'll invite you to my party. I'll invite you to the moonshine party. Boom! Oh, you... No, chicken for me. She rode the KFC. Get out of here.
No. No.
Woo! Yes. That was some... That's clutch there. I can't avoid... Remember, don't die. If you could literally get two or three kills, and if you have 3-0, you're going to have a good chance to win. And right now, I'm picking on this sack boy. I think I already killed sack boy twice. So 3 kills. Woo. Nice. And that rhymes. Come here. Oh, that's right. No one wants to mess with me. Of course, a tip for Sir Daniel players, you could always go ahead and roll over those cakes. You could roll over mines, but you cannot roll over Isaac's mines, so you could absorb those still, and that's a great thing to do against sack boys. Let's go roll! No! That little sleepy, dopey dwarf, whatever you... Oh, man, too soon. That little sleepy dwarf stopped me from getting my cookies action, denied me. He just saw that I love cookies, and he... said no. Come here. I'm sorry. I'm going to pick on you, little sack boy, because it's easy to. Oh, come on. Yes. Cookies. Oh, man. Don't forget, if you're playing the kid-friendly drinking game, every time I say cookies, take a bite of your cookie and dip it in milk. If you're playing the adult drinking game, if you're over 21, take a shot. Take a shot of your favorite drink. Take a shot of your hoochie hooch. Yes, sir. But please, do not drive anywhere. Stay at home drunk. Yes. Oh, no. Fat princess.
Cake, please.
You cake girl. Hold. Oh, I almost William Wallace. I'm going after the fat princess because I know she's in the lead. And you always go after the top dog because you don't want to... it's useless to poach kills, but hey, if you can, here we go, cookies, yes, cookies, you take that, fat princess. Was that enough for me? No,
cake, please.
Oh, I died one too many times, and fat princess, at least I'm second, and we're back in 93, oh, this match, I'm feeling it in my bones, I'm getting close to that purple belt, we're going, looks like, let's see, these Kratos, okay, I think I could get this here, and Perry, wee. You guys remember that show, All That? Remember that show on Nickelodeon? And Kenan Thompson, for those people that are young, Kenan Thompson did not get a start on Saturday Night Live. He did not get a start there. He got a start on a great show back in the day, in the 90s, of Nick and Knight called All That, and he played a French guy who pretended to know French. And all he would say is, like, my cheese is old and moldy. And he was in a bathtub. Hilarious. Hilarious when you're a child. Not so hilarious when you're growing up. But nostalgic moment for you guys who are born in the 85 era, who's a 90s kid. Oh, we miss the 90s. I never thought growing up that I'd be able to play video games with people all around the world. And certainly I never thought that I could have my videos be watched all over the world. So... welcome to all those international fans of SanchoWest. You know, it's pretty cool knowing that people from Poland, Uruguay, watch this game. That kind of reminds me of Carmen Sandiego. Another nostalgic moment for you guys. Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Yeah. So let's go back to this match. I got 2 Kratos right now, and I'm close to this purple belt. If I get this match in the books, then, you know, we're there. Yeah, that long sword thrust. And, you know, oh, nice work. Woo, that was close. Let's go. Oh, they missed. It's just the slightest movement there. And the thing is, I didn't have Ratchet pinned against the wall completely. And that's why I missed my level 1. But I'm okay. I could build up meter real fast. Oh, yes. Oh, almost had cookies. Almost had cookies. Let's do it again. Wow. A lot of pandemonium action going here. It's a slobber knocker, as good old JR would say. The slobber knocker of action right now. Everybody is getting punished. A lot of opportunities are available here in this game. So, wow, that's intense. I definitely helped him out there. That's a good thing. Oh, man. You guys are going to see that in the 2v2 series, that Sir Daniel's a great, great support character, especially with his battle axe. It could actually confirm a lot of kills. You know, if you're playing with a Sir Dan player in 2v2, have your partner throw out the battle axe and pay attention to that, because it is what we like to call in the fighting community a butt drop. When you get hit with that battle axe, oh man, I am pushing it. I just think, because I was so close to purple belt last time, I don't want to fall down to 50 again, and I'm just whiffing my level 2 left and right, and everything's just an inch too high. Just an inch too high, and I'm whiffing. So let's see what I can do in the last 10 seconds. Of course, that's the money time. That is the golden hour. Come here. That's the Mr. Clutch time. Let's see if I can get something going. Get some cookies. Come here. Oh, no. Oh, you're not going to kill me. No. Not a victory for Sir Dan. And he's in last place. I was level belt rank 93. And hopefully I don't drop down too far. Oh, 84. Maybe I was 89 before, but now I'm 84. No, Cherie. I need this victory to get back in the W column, and you know, against some blue belts. And I don't know what happened here. There's no belts here, so if I lose, this is not going to bode well for me. I will probably drop down in the 70s. I went ahead and switched up my armor. I got the red Ranger armor right now. Going to go into Zord mode and just go bananas. I really do really well in this stage. I come across watching, I do watch my videos again, not to be egotistical or not to hear my own voice. I watch them just to see what works in terms of comedy and whatnot and gameplay. Kind of like a quarterback watches some gameplay videos just to see what's going on, how can I do better. So I watch these videos, and at this stage, every time I feel like I do really well. So let's see what I can do to get back in the win column. Come here. Boom. Yeah. See that? That was a William Wallace moment. Hold. You want to use those platforms as your amigo. And so you could use your arrows. As you saw there, I knew he was going to tech roll somewhere, but usually they go to the right majority of the times. Pow. All right, here we go. 2 kills. I'm feeling good. Getting my rhythm. I mean, I should win this match. There's only a blue belt on the board. And I'm going to use these platforms. At first, to be honest, I hated these platforms. I'm not going to lie. Damn you, Emo Dante. I used to hate these platforms. I used to hate platforms, period. Because it would affect my bread and butter arrow combo, because they would pretty much fall onto that platform. But now, being older and wiser with Sir Dan, I use these platforms as my friends. And my old partner, B Magical One, would attest to that I used to hate platforms. But, you know, I live and I learn, and I get better with Sir Dan. Come here. Let's go. Oh, damn you, Emo Dante. Don't you guys want some drink? Here we go. Yeah. Oh, one. Yes. Oh. Emo Dante, you're denying people their cookies. There's a lot of people with a glass of milk and cookies in their hand right now. They're watching this so they could go ahead and play and be a part of the kid-friendly drinking game. No. If I only had super. I had a happy birthday moment right there, but if I only had a super, you guys could have dunked your little cookie into your milk. But is it there? No. Close. At least I got that kill for Emo Dante, because he got a double kill earlier. And Kratos is going raw. Kratos! Square. Yeah, you missing me. Yeah. Oh, what? Dang, you lag. Kratos is definitely in the lead now when it went to work with his level 3. You know, that's the strategy. If you're a Kratos player, you know who you are. Kratos players, you want to go for your level 3. You don't want to stick with your level 1, because, you know, that's a waste of Kratos' talent. His level 3 is very powerful. And right now I'm trying to avoid Sweet Tooth there from getting his mech warrior. You don't want that to happen. So, think I knocked somebody back down into that super. You owe me some money there, Emo Dante. Come here, come here. Yes. Oh, man. So I was saying, you don't want people to hit their level 3, so pay attention. Ah, oh, wow. I don't know. That usually goes through that. I'm getting lucky right here. I'm not dying on the worst super in the world. Ha ha. Was that enough? Yes. DJ, play my music. Yes. What a way to end sweet 16 episode. Like, share, subscribe. Genuine. Play us out. Yeah.